The release date for The Last of Us Part 2 is just around the corner, and in celebration of the fact that our wait is finally over, we thought it might be time to share some of the scariest theories we've heard in regards to the much-anticipated sequel. Welcome back, my fellow gamers. My name is Amanda McKnight, and I will be your host for this Top 10 Gaming video today, where we'll be counting down the Top 10 Scary Last of Us 2 Theories. We hope that you are as excited as us when it comes to this new title. The road has been long and tumultuous for Naughty Dog's The Last of Us 2, but it's finally almost time for this game to release. After just over 7 years, it's almost time to venture back into the bleak world full of zombies and find out how Ellie and Joel's story will continue to unfold. But what will their story entail? Join me today where we'll be looking at some of the theories involving what we might be able to expect in this sequel. And be sure to stick around till the end of this list where I will have some bonus content. All right, let's get counting. Number 10, it won't live up to the hype. I put this theory really low on the list because the early reviews have been overwhelmingly positive. But the issue with some of them that fans have noticed is that reviews have had a hard time speaking to just what specifically their criticisms are. This is due to spoilers, trying to avoid those. So while reviews have been overwhelmingly amazing, some fans worry that the shift that we know will happen in the story could leave them disappointed as opposed to awed and amazed. Only time will tell, but personally, I feel the game will manage to live up to all the hype and wow the fans. But I understand that the reviews being less specific and some of the leaks that have happened is cause for concern among those who love The Last of Us and its characters so much. Number 9. Joel is ostracized. Some have theorized based on the trailer that Joel's secret is somehow revealed, and that he, as a result, gets ostracized from Ellie's life. Or there is the potential that Joel is forced to do something awful at the beginning of Last of Us 2, which causes him to become an outcast. He could be kicked out of the community or forced to live on the outskirts, and Ellie and Joel's relationship, as such, could end up being in a pretty rough state for most of the game, if not for all of it. Now, this wouldn't be completely in line with the relationship it seems that the first game was working to build and establish, so let's hope that if Ellie and Joel do have something that separates them, that they eventually will forgive one another. Number 8. Ellie becomes infected. This one seems pretty unlikely based on what we know from the first game and what we've seen in sneak peeks into gameplay and cinematics, but it could be possible, and it would definitely be a big unexpected twist. It's possible that while we thought Ellie was immune in the first game, we later find out that her infection is just super delayed, or that she might be becoming some kind of human-zombie hybrid. So she's still part zombie, and perhaps even more aggressive as a result. There are theories that her brain fungus will be revealed as being deadly, and that Ellie's life will once more be in danger, and she could even die. Other theories pose that the brain fungus might make her stronger, and actually grant her more zombie-like superpowers. Which could be cool or could be really lame, depending on how balanced her superpowers are in gameplay and whether or not they make her too overpowered of a character. Number 7, By the Sea. It has been revealed that the sequel for The Last of Us Part 2 will have new locations for us to explore. Just what we'll find there, we'll have to wait and see. But with new locations to explore, there are likely new enemies and zombies awaiting us in the game. In a preview of the game on IGN, Naughty Dog confirmed with viewers that there would be new locations for us to explore in this game. One of the locations could be California, as we do know part of our adventure will take place in the Pacific Northwest. I'm personally hoping that we'll get a visit to San Diego at some point myself, although we do know we will be visiting Seattle for sure, and that Seattle plays a big role in the story of the game. But what's more, if we're going to the coast, I'm also hoping that we get some kind of terrifying beach or underwater sequence to go along with wherever the story takes us along that coastline. Number 6, Dina betrays Ellie. In The Last of Us 2, we are introduced to a new character, Dina, who we know is a friend of Ellie's, who later on becomes a love interest. We also know that at some point in the game, Dina is one of your allies, though it's uncertain if this is before or after Ellie leaves Jackson County. It is possible that Dina joins Ellie on her journey or is even part of what motivates Ellie to set out again. But of course, with anyone that you get romantic with in almost any game, it's hard to completely trust them. In many stories, romantic partners also make for really good betrayers, and it could be possible that Dina is luring Ellie away from Jackson as part of some kind of insidious plot. Number 5, Joel won't be playable. While almost every fan seems to have thoroughly enjoyed Ellie's playable segment in the first Last of Us, it seems that this time around, Ellie will become the main playable character. And while she has allies alongside her, likely even at some point Joel, it's unclear as to how big of a role Joel gets to play in this game. We know he's in there, but will he be a playable character? There are theories that Joel will be an ally and a main character for the story, but that we might not get to play as him this time around. In fact, we may not get to play as anyone else other than Ellie, which for Joel fans, I think would be a pretty big bummer. Number 4, what the Seraphites want. We know in The Last of Us 2, there will be two warring factions that Ellie is forced to face as enemies, fight and hide from. And there'll be at least two warring factions. There could even be more, for all we know. One of them is the terrifying Seraphite, or Scars, a fanatic religious faction that stand out due to the scars that they give themselves to signify that they belong. They all pretty much seem to have Glasgow smiles. They are ruthless and violent, and odds are good they want to get their hands on survivors like Ellie in order to judge them and purge them of their sin. It is possible they are hunting Ellie because they find out about her relationship with Dina. We have also seen the Scars sacrificing those they believe to be sinners, and it is possible that they attempt to sacrifice Ellie and maybe even succeed in sacrificing Dina. Number 3, new zombies that we haven't seen yet. We have been teased when it comes to the types of upcoming zombies we'll be seeing in the new game, but Naughty Dog has confirmed that they haven't revealed all of the new zombies and their new stages of evolution or severity of infection just yet. They're keeping a few top secret to surprise us with. Surprise zombies, not a good real-life surprise, but a pretty good in-game surprise for sure. A lot of the special types of zombies that have been revealed as being part of The Last of Us 2 game seem to share similarities with another game's cast of special zombos, Left 4 Dead. Runners are kind of like chargers, clickers like smokers, stalkers like hunters, shamblers like boomers, and spitters kind of combined. A few we haven't heard them mention, though, when it comes to these similar types to Left 4 Dead, are anything similar to tanks and witches. A few of the most frightening kinds of zombies in the Left 4 Dead game. This theory poses that their game will also have their own versions or spins on these massively powerful types of zombies, though we'll have to wait till we play to see just what kind of spin The Last of Us 2 will put on these types, should they appear. Number 2, Joel dies. While we know that Joel will appear again later in the game, he does seem to be somewhat absent based on what we've seen, for at least a good chunk of it. In this game, we know that Ellie always has an ally, but this time around, the ally that you travel with will appear to swap out for another character every now and then. There is a theory that when Joel does show up again, it might be the last time that we actually get to see him in this story forever, because he will die. We know from the cinematics that we've seen that Joel does eventually join Ellie on her journey, or at least he appears to. And there is a theory that this happens partway through the game, and it is Joel's death while adventuring with her that causes the plot shift that many reviews have been talking about. Number 1, Joel becomes a zombie. Another theory as to Joel's fate is that we will see him become a zombie later in the game while adventuring with Ellie. That Ellie could be out for revenge because the Fireflies were initially going to kill her to make a cure. And when she discovers this, that information combined with a mysterious trauma of some kind that she experiences, possibly caused by a former member of the Fireflies or a member themselves that has followed her, will cause her to seek out their faction once more. And it is during this adventure that Joel joins her and becomes infected, which could inspire Ellie to find a new way to create a cure. This could potentially be the plot shift people are talking about, where it kind of goes from being a revenge mission to some kind of rescue mission. And it's a race to try and save Joel or just save humanity in his name. Thank you so much for watching. What sort of environments are you hoping to explore in The Last of Us 2? What sort of secrets do you think the plot might reveal? Are you hoping that Joel will also make a prominent return? Let us know in the comments below. And if you are as excited as we are for The Last of Us Part 2, be sure to show it in the comments and by giving this video a thumbs up. This has been Top 10 Gaming, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight, reminding you, as always, to keep on gaming on. Pew pew!